Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Now, this is a wee sort of video that sort of adds on to the video I did about mother guitars. I just felt awful guilty that I never gave the resonator much time. Now, the resonator guitar goes away back to the 20s. Years and years ago, at the sort of beginning of the blues music. And the whole reason for a resonator guitar was so people could play in chapels and churches and town halls and all these places, and their guitar could be heard all over. The sound would resonate, a resophonic sound, that's what it's called. And it's created by a cone in here. If you take this off, there's like a cone, and it's all done, that's what you call them, it's all done by cones, and it resonates the sound out. They were very, very quickly taken over when the sort of amplifiers came in and you had electric guitars. But that was the whole idea of a resonator guitar. It was before amplifiers were invented, and people, especially the Mississippi Delta blues players and all that sort of stuff, even away before folk music, I think it goes down to the blues stuff, that the sound would resonate in the hall so that more people could hear the music. But it's a very distinctive sound, and that's why I love the resonator. It's, as folk would say, it's a very vulgar guitar, because it's got lovers in canoes and palm trees and all that on the back, and it's all engraved and what have you. But you can hear it resonating, hear it. It's different from acoustic, and I just love the sound. They play a lot of slide guitar on it, and it's, a lot of people play the resonator in open G. But I don't really like open chord. I don't like open tuning, open G, open D. I like everything in standard tuning, which is E, E, A, D, G, B, E. And then I change the key we use in a capo. And I can keep the same chord shapes, because the chord shapes change when you start getting into open chords. But that's the whole idea. They're very, very hard to maintain, because they tarnish. They tarnish a lot. Sweat from your arms. When you put the heating on in the winter, they all tend to tarnish. And the best way is actually to just use like sort of Silvo. You get a tin of Silvo, and you can, when I change my strings, I strip it all down and I clean it all with Silvo. And it really is something special. It's a beautiful guitar. And as I say, it's got a lovely sort of resophonic sound. So that's a resonator guitar. Okay.